Guess who's back? It's me, Odooers, back to school you about shop floor. This time, we're focusing on components. More specifically, we will see how to use the shop floor module to scrap or add components for a manufacturing order. Sometimes, a component used in a manufacturing order can be defective and must be scrapped. In some cases, we realize that an extra component is needed during the manufacturing process. Luckily, shop floor gives us the flexibility to scrap or add components in the middle of manufacturing. Pretty cool, right? Let's see how it works. Before we get started, I want to mention that we'll be using two-step manufacturing for this workflow. Everything you see in this video will also apply to three-step manufacturing as well. Multi-step manufacturing requires an additional step, picking, which means that components must be picked from inventory in order to be used for manufacturing. This will affect how components are added to and scrapped from manufacturing orders. Picking isn't absolutely necessary for adding or scrapping components from a memo, but I want to show you how to do it, just in case your company uses two or three-step manufacturing. If you're using one-step manufacturing, you can still follow the workflow. The only difference is you don't need to process any picking operations. Don't worry though, inventory counts will still update correctly based on the total number of components used. To choose the number of steps you use for manufacturing, simply open the inventory app, click on Configuration, then Warehouses. Select a warehouse and enable one of the three options in the Manufacture section. As you can see, we have two-step manufacturing selected. Now let's head back to the Odoo dashboard. All right, with that out of the way, let's jump into shop floor and get started. Now I've set up a manufacturing order for a coffee table to use as an example for today. Let me search for the MO number so we can focus on it. Nice, with the MO isolated, let's go ahead and open the options menu by clicking on the three vertical dots button at the bottom right corner of the MO card. Then I'll click on the scrap button to open the scrap pop-up menu. From here, I can select one of the components used to manufacture the coffee table in the product field. Let's say that upon receiving required components, I discovered that one of our 3-inch quarter screws was bent at a 90-degree angle. That's gonna make it pretty hard to use. No big deal, I'll just select the screw in the product field. I can also specify a quantity in case we need to scrap more than one component. In this case, it's just one screw that's a little screwy. After selecting the product, I'm also going to check on the Replenish Scrapped Quantities box. Doing so means that a pick components transfer will automatically be created to transfer a new screw to our product location. Don't worry about checking that box if you're using one-step manufacturing, though. Since one-step manufacturing doesn't use picking, checking the Replenish Scrap Quantities will cause an error when you try to validate the scrap order. Speaking of which, let's go ahead and validate the scrap order. Now wait a second, where did the MO go? I think we need to form a search party. Just kidding, Odooers, I actually knew that would happen. How you ask? Well, by default, ShopFloor has the Ready to Start filter enabled in the search bar. Since we scrapped one of the screws that we need to assemble the coffee table, the MO is no longer ready to start. If I want to see the MO, I can just remove the filter. And there's our MO. Now, let's focus on getting a replacement screw. Since we enabled the Replenish Scrap Quantities button on the scrap order, a picking order for one screw was automatically created. Let's open that picking order now by clicking Close, navigating to the Inventory app, clicking One to Process, and selecting the most recent order. Awesome. Now I'll just validate this picking order and mark it as all done. Alrighty, before we head back to shop floor, I'm gonna go back to the manufacturing app to confirm that all of the required components are available. Let's go to Operations, Manufacturing Orders, and select the MO for the coffee table. In the chatter, I can see that the MO is still in its waiting stage, which means that it still won't appear as ready to start in the shop floor module. However, when I click the Check Availability button at the top of the form, Odoo recognizes that the replacement screw is now available and the chatter updates to reflect that the MO is ready. Very cool. Now let's head back into the shop floor module. From here, I'll just search the number of our MO again. And boom, the MO appears once again, even with the Ready to Start filter enabled. Now I can continue processing the MO as I normally would. So we just learned how to scrap a component from an MO and transfer a replacement. But what about when you need to add an extra component when none of it has been scrapped? Well, the process is similar, but there are a few key differences that I want to show you. I'll use the same MO for this example and start by clicking on the Options button like before. This time, I'm going to select the Add component from the pop-up window. In the Add component window, let's say we need to add an extra screw to this MO. To do that, I'll select the screw from the product drop-down menu. We can also select the quantity, but I'll just leave it as 1. Then I'll click Add component. Once again, the MO disappears from the Ready to Start view because we're missing the extra component. Now here is the key difference between replacing a scrap component and adding a new component. Remember the Replace Scrap Component option on the Scrap pop-up menu? Well, you may have noticed that there was no equivalent option on the Add Component pop-up menu. This means we need to manually create the picking transfer for the extra screw. To do so, I'll close Shop Floor and head over to the Inventory app. Then I'll click on Pick Components and create a new picking. Next, I need to add 1 unit of our screw to the Detailed Operations tab, and I'll enter in 1. And then I'll validate the transfer. Now, unlike with the scrap component, we don't need to click check availability on the MO to make the MO ready again. This means that when we head back to shop floor, the MO automatically appears as ready to start, allowing it to process it as usual. This was quite a bit of information, Odooers, but I really appreciate you sticking with me until the end. Great job today, and I'll see you soon!